Let me take a rubber band and break it. I'll tie a knot at one end. I'll lock it in this gap of an empty box. If I stretch it and pluck it, what will happen? It will vibrate and we will hear the sound. What if I stretch it further? Will I hear the same sound? No. Sound changes. As you know, vibrations are key to sound generation. Less vibrations result in lower frequency or pitch. Pitch is how we feel or hear sound. It is closely related to frequency. Higher the frequency, higher the pitch. Lower the frequency, lower the pitch. This guitar has lots of strings. You can hear different sounds when you pluck these. Let me pluck this one and this one. Which one has a low pitch sound? The last one is the low pitch sound. First one is a high pitch sound. Why are these different pitches on the same guitar? If you look at the wires closely, they are of different material. The thickness of each wire is different. There are many factors which decide how vibrations are generated. I can change the length of vibrating wire by placing my finger here. I reduce the length, higher the pitch. I increase the length, lower pitch. Here, I can increase tension of the wire and change the pitch as well. Let's give it a try. Increasing tension results in higher or lower pitch? Higher pitch. No guitar? No problem. We can take this rubber band as well and try these things out ourselves. We'll attach it to this plastic container, increase the length and pluck it again. Tension has also increased. Can I keep the tension same and reduce the length? This is how we do it. I will use the pencil. How to increase the thickness of the rubber? We can attach another rubber, twist it, and try it again. Can we use different type of rubber? Can we increase the amplitude of the sound produced? Discuss it with friends and find out yourself. Same exercise can be done with string and tin box. You can loosen and stretch the string to increase and decrease the tension and accordingly change the pitch. We tried it with rubber and guitar. How about wind instruments? These instruments also have high and low pitch sound. This large straw produces a sound. This is a low pitch sound. This one produces a high pitch sound. We can use this empty glass bottle and blow air at the mouth. Air column inside the bottle vibrates, resulting in sound. This is low pitch sound. Less vibrations. Let me add some water now. Now you will hear a different sound. This is a high pitch sound. Try similar activity with your friends and identify high and low pitch sounds around you. We know that when objects vibrate, sound waves are introduced in the medium. Medium transports energy from one particle to another. Amount of energy transferred to the medium is due to vibrating object. More the energy applied for object to vibrate, the more the amplitude of vibrations. Intensity of vibrations is proportional to to the square of amplitude. The amount of sound energy which is transported past a given area of the medium per unit of time is known as the intensity of the sound wave. Intensity of the sound wave is expressed in watts per meter squared. As we move away from the source of sound, area increases and intensity of sound decreases. Decibel is the unit of measuring sound intensity. We will use Science Journal app to measure the intensity of sound produced by this speaker. As we move our mobile away from the speaker, the intensity of sound produced reduces. Intensity of sound level is calculated with the help of formula. We'll not talk about it for now. This sound is of magnitude 1 decibel. It is similar to the sound we produce when we whisper. Here is how decibels scale when heard sounds like 1 decibel sound, 10 decibel watch ticking, 30 decibel leaves rustling, 50 decibel normal conversation of people at 1 meter distance,
paper, wool, cotton, leather,
60 decibel singing, loud talking, 80 decibel jackhammer, construction hammering, take shot of metro drilling, 100 decibel police car, ambulance, 120 decibel rock concert, hip hop music, 130 decibel gunshots or jet engines. During festivals like Ganesh Puja, Dahi Handi, Durga Puja, we normally hear loud music. During festive season, processions are accompanied with walls of speakers. This is not good for our ears. Elderly people or infants may have bad effects on their health. We should follow sound limits as prescribed by government or local bodies. Summary. We discussed what pitch is and how intensity of sound is measured. Intensity of vibrations is proportional to the square of amplitude. Decibel is a unit of measuring sound level.